So, transport yesterday for me was definitely not on my side, yeah. I'm getting so sick and tired. This is why I don't support anything to do with politics or government or anything. And this is why, I know it's shameful, but this is why I actually don't vote. Before, I didn't vote because I didn't know how to, because I was younger. Now, I just don't vote because I just never see a point in it. Like, at the end of the day, no matter who I vote for, it's not going to be in a better favour for me as a black person living in Britain. So, nothing is ever in our favour when it comes to stuff like that. When you are proper, like, a normal citizen, going on normal buses, topping up how we top up and having to fork out the money we fork out for the services that you lot say you change, but you put the money up for and you still give us the same stupid service, even worse than last year, but you want to keep putting money up every single year on things. Interest always goes up on things. Food constantly goes up. I remember when I used to pay 40 pence. That was 40p and it used to be 70p for an adult. And I'm not that old, I'm 27, so if that wasn't that long ago, and now it's ridiculous. Like, prices are ridiculous. I don't even want to say how much I spend living here only in the South End to keep going to London. It's a fortune. So, and it's a fortune that you don't get back. I don't have a problem paying that. Evidently, what I have a problem with is not getting a sufficient service for my money. Like, how are you going to keep putting my money up and keep giving me the worst service all the time? Like, trains are delayed. There's always, every single weekend, there's engineering networks. How much engineering works could there be every weekend for how many years? Like, how much rock do you need to turn over on a track? I don't understand. And you want me to be happy with you taking my money? Oh, what did you do that you're even increasing the fares? Is it for people's wages? Not really, so we can get nicer trains. What the point is of having a nice train if it's not even going to be sufficient in the time that I need it to be? People have got things to do, you know. You just want to keep delaying. Then when people are stuck in the middle of the nowhere, we have to get cabs. Thank God for money, because if I don't have money, for the people that don't have money and are stranded, which I have been before a few times, because of your irresponsibility in not even notifying people when things could possibly go wrong. They don't even give a flying toss. They just care about the name and the power that they're in. They don't really care. Like, I will never vote unless there's someone, a normal uprighting citizen, just someone who I feel like can relate to myself, like, doesn't have the most, and it's just normal. Like, that's the only way that I will ever believe that anything will ever be able to accurately change in any sort of country, is if you have normal people running a country that knows what people on benefits have to deal with, that know what it's like to go on transport and to know when your trains are really delayed all the time, to be forking out that money out of your own money, not your government driven cars, for you to be saying that you're going to make a change on transport. Please, these stupid bikes that are in London that half the time don't even work when you put your card in, and then it's even expensive riding those bikes, you know. It's just everything in London is getting so expensive so unnecessarily, and I don't understand why you people keep putting up money for things and I'm not getting the accurate services that I need for anything. You can't even get Sky. Sometimes people just want Sky. Why does it have to be Dish? You have to have Lime Rent, you have to have Dish, why can't you just buy a service for it just to be a service with no added extras of anything? When you want to rent a house, council tax, water, TV license, I can go on, gas, electric. Like, why is there so much of everything? Like, these people, yeah, want to put people in extortion. And you wonder how much people are getting into debt. Like, imagine leaving uni already with your degree. You can't even be happy because you already got 50 grand over your head. 50 grand and over your first, imagine you should be happy getting your first job. And some people are very fortunate. Very small percentage of people are fortunate to leave uni and to get a job straight after. And then after 21, if you earn after 21 grand, that's when they start taking bits of your student loan out. Which, okay, I do think they should put that threshold higher, because 21,000 a year isn't even a lot anyway. And if you're getting yourself together and you've gone through uni on your own as an individual, you need time to set yourself up properly before they start taking money like that. Just, they don't care about anything to do with us. Like, I really feel like going to down the street myself, stripping off and doing my own protest, because I don't understand what is going on, to be honest. Money is going up. I don't understand why, because people are giving me shit. It's like, you're taking my money and just giving me shit. Oh, I'm so annoyed. Yesterday, It took me 4 hours to get home. And it's not because I live far. I don't care what people say. It's so annoying people say that. I don't care if I lived in flipping, if I lived 5-6 hours away. I don't care if I had to go to Edinburgh in the morning. Fact of the matter is, trains, that the amount of money that you pay, the amount of money that these people take every year when they're putting up your money, when everything is going up, the trains should be damn right sufficient. We should have had 24-hour trains all lined from ages ago. It shouldn't have even been something that's a big thing. And now there's 24-hour trains. There's only 2 24-hour trains. And they don't even run at every single station. Only chosen stations. Like, what the hell is going on? But then you want to keep putting out money. You want to keep taking money and not giving people services that they're meant to be having accurately for their money. Me, I'm getting another car this week because I'm not trusting Thingy Bob. And you know what? You better mind me, I'm African, right? So I know stuff. And if I need to do tax evasion, I would. And I'm saying it loud and proud. Because unless you start showing me why you should be deserving to take my money for this society that we're meant to be living for, this stupid country, then, listen, let me tell you something, you this Boris Mammoth. Then, I will let you take you. Nonsense.